everyone, and welcome to UCI. My name is Kristen. I'm a fourth year dance major with a minor in business management. And coming to you today from our lovely UCI campus, I'm here with my good friend, Adam.
Hey everyone, my name is Adam Rodriguez. I'm also a fourth year, however, I'm studying sociology, but also with business management. So we'll just be taking you on a small tour and getting to show and highlight the different parts of the UCI's campus. So right now we're launching social sciences. Social sciences is not the newest addition to the university, however, it's still one of the oldest standing majors and schools within the university. So we're now entering Social Science Plaza. The next really two cool buildings I want to show y'all is the Social Science Tower, which we are passing right now, and the Social Science Lab. So within the lab, there's no actual windows in this building. Why? Because we conduct sleep studies in there. This is really cool. A lot of students do take advantage of that for extra credit and just for cash and gift cards as well. Yeah, within the Social Science Plaza, we not only do we have social sciences, but we have social ecology as well. That is another staple here at the university. One of the best programs within that school is the criminology program. So I highly recommend, if there are any alumni from the criminology program, come out and connect with students within the program, see how they're doing, and just to see like if they have any questions about what you're doing as well. I don't know if y'all remember, but Middle Earth is actually from a very popular book by J.R.R. Tolkien. So it's actually
Star Wars.
Yeah, I think you got it right. Actually, yeah. It's actually Lord of the Rings or The Hobbit by J.R.R. Tolkien. So whenever I have friends that say that they lived in Middle Earth, I always like to say that's what I'm talking about. So that's actually a really, really funny joke. Unfortunately, no, Kristen doesn't approve of my jokes today, but on my tours, they really hit different. But so one of the biggest renovations is actually the Middle Earth Towers. Middle Earth Towers have been constructed. They were constructed in 2019. So they're fairly new. So about a year or two old. So one of the really cool things is Brandywine. Brandywine is just one of the different common areas for meals and just a wide variety of different other things as well. Also, I actually love Middle Earth for the amount of nature that surrounded it, but it also gives me a little bit more of like Mesa Court vibes because of the colors and the color scheme that's associated with it.
The nice thing about the Middle Earth Towers is it is contrasting from the classic halls. So you'll see there's a little bit of a different color scheme with the classics versus the towers, but I think that makes it so special to just see the difference in how campus is evolving and renovating itself for the modern times.
So right now we are passing the School of Engineering. School of Engineering is just one of the newest, I want to say most modern parts of the university.
So now we're heading off into physical sciences, and this is where we're actually going to find some of our newest renovations.
One of the newest buildings here on campus. It's dedicated to lab spaces as well as study spaces for students. So just a few buildings we want to highlight is McGall Hall. The reason why it's called McGall Hall is because every time you see it, you say, oh my God. Nah, I'm just kidding, folks. McGall Hall is actually one of the most expensive buildings on campus. Why? Because of the amount of research equipment that goes on in there. Also, the science library. The science library is actually really, really nice.
Fun fact, science library actually has a little courtyard in the middle of it. And for some classes, they actually go and utilize that courtyard. For me, I actually spent a class, one of my dance classes, dancing in the middle of the courtyard of science library.
Now I want to introduce the newest building on campus. Yes, you've guessed it, the Anteater Learning Pavilion. The Anteater Learning Pavilion is more of a collaborative learning experience for students. So every seat in this lecture hall is actually connected to another seat. So when your professors say, hey, find a partner, you'll never have the excuse of not having one. It's actually really, really nice. A great amount of study spaces, I wanna say, as well as it's connected to our Learning Academic Resource Center, so LARC. So for a lot of the students who wanna take advantage of that tutoring.
Also, what's really nice about ALP is that it's mostly all interactive. So you have TV screens that you can do your projects on. Like Adam was saying, you have those connected chairs so you're able to move around with your teams. But also the nice thing about it is it stays quiet for a majority of the time. So if you do need to study or anything like that, it is a great place to go, especially if you need some more hands-on learning that you can't find in some of the other buildings.
Yeah, so the next school that we're just passing by right now is the School of Humanities. School of Humanities is still one of the longest standing schools here in the university. However, we just added a little bit more, and unfortunately I wish the trees were blossoming right now so we can at least see that. But we are now entering in one of the most beautiful schools that I say is on part of campus, UCI School of the Arts.
The nice thing about UCI Arts is that there's always something new happening here. Even though we're not on campus currently, we are still finding ways to bring the arts to people at home. So whether it be a dance performance via Zoom or pre-recorded, or having different visual arts students work on editing and different, you know, pieces of art that they want to showcase in their virtual galleries, this is a great place to come and just be reminded of all the new and exciting things that are happening within the School of the Arts.
One thing I actually love about the School of the Arts is the amount of color that's introduced into the school. So we have the green room. We have the
best coffee place on campus by far. If you've never been to the green room, when it opens back up, you have to go check it out. It is a staple for any arts major to go there, study, hang out with friends, work on projects, but it also has what I think is the best coffee on campus.
That is true.
I might be a little biased, but.
Also, I just love the colors, you know. I come here and study and sometimes, oftentimes, take a nap because it's just that warm.
Oh, this is a great place to take a nap. Now we're just going closer to where all the studios are. Unfortunately, right now they aren't open, but they have been redesigned with new Marley floor. So if you used to be a dance major and you had different flooring, well, we got some new flooring in about 2 years ago, making it a lot easier for some of the arts students to do their rehearsals and things like that.
So we're now entering one of the second residential living areas. I like to call this home. Why? Because I'm a residential advisor for the university.
Wow.
I actually do live on Caballo 4. So let me see if I can pop. Wait, you can fit it through here, right?
Yeah.
Okay, sweet. So one of the few newest additions to Mesa Court, unfortunately, they're not the newest. They're about 4 years old, I want to say, 4 or 5.
Yeah.
Are the Middle Earth, not Middle Earth, the Mesa Court Towers. So I'm actually located in Caballo 4 and just a nice little area. I also love the little theme that Mesa has here. It kind of resonates with the School of the Arts with the different color schemes, as well as just the different livable areas. So unfortunately, we have been altered. A lot of students do not have roommates this year. Why? Because we're just adjusting to the COVID-19 situation. However, the Anteatery is still open. The Anteatery has been the replacement for Brandywine, the commons that were found in Lot 5, for many of you who actually remember. So that's actually really nice. It is takeout only. You cannot sit in it, but I do recommend you come and check out the school and just the different livable residential areas as well.
So if you're able to see it, this is my old hall when I was a freshman. Definitely some great times. I remember being able to live with friends and just have a great experience. And I think that that's something that stands true with UCI, is that the connections that you make will stand the test of time, and that you'll always have those connections, whether it be from classes or living situations or different clubs and organizations that you're a part of. It's always something that you can reconnect with those people and remember all the good times that you had back in the day.
Yep. So I just want to give a quick shout out to my roommate Greg, yes, and all the buddies from Cumbre. So I did also live in Mesa Court my first year and absolutely fell in love with it. I still connect with my friends to this day, and that just goes to show, highlighting what Kristen said, your friendships will last the test of time, especially in college. We are right now in the Student Center. The Student Center, before COVID, used to have a wide variety of different events within the Student Center Terrace. We have ASUCI, we have the pub for all you alumni, we have different ATMs, the biggest form of communication between parents and students, yes. So the Cross Cultural Center, we are passing it on my right. The Cross Cultural Center houses a lot of the umbrella groups here on the university. So the Black Student Union, the Asian Pacific Islander Student Association, and a wide variety of others as well, which is really nice just to connect and just find your sense of identity within these organizations. So yeah, so now I think we are entering the easiest part of the tour. Why? Because it is kind of like a walk in the park, but in this case, it's a little ride in the park. Sorry, I just had to include that. So within Aldridge Park, it's one of the most biggest staples here at the university. Why? Because they house a lot of different events, as well as just a nice place to come and relax for a lot of students. So within the park, we've actually upped the amount of trees that we have. We have over 11,122 trees, but I want to say it's 11,121. Why? Because I broke one when I set up my hammock in the park. I'm just kidding, folks. But it's just a nice way to connect to nature and just really like centralizes the university. So it's just a little small hub on campus.
One of the nice things that UCI did is they actually started setting up different chairs around Aldridge Park for students to come out, hang out with each other, socially distance. But I remember I actually came here one night with a couple of friends, and we were able to all sit around right next to a Christmas tree that they had planted. And that was something that we did right before the end of the 2020 year, So it's very nice to see that UCI is accommodating to a lot of COVID protocols, but also just making sure that we still have a sense of community on campus, even during these troubling times.
Also, one of the biggest staples within the park is it not only is it its trees or the place of gathering, we actually have the Infinity Fountain very, very close to it. One of my favorite parts on campus, why? Because it holds a lot of different things, as well as like I have a lot of memories here. As they say, the Infinity Fountain gives you a lot of infinite amount of memories at the university. A lot of your professors will say it's the infinite amount of knowledge. However, we like to say it's the infinite amount of walking that you do at the university.
Yep. So right now we're heading into the Paul Mirage School of Business. We normally don't show this and feature it on our normal tours when we are on campus, just because it is a little bit out of the way, but we are going to show it to you today, just a little bit of it. So the nice thing about Paul Mirage School of Business is because it is a little bit secluded, you're going to only be surrounded by a lot of the same majors. So whether it be business administration, business information management, or if you have a minor like Adam and I do in both business management. One of the nice things about Paul Mirage is that they did add in like an addition of light. So if you ever want to come study late at night, you don't have to worry about having it be too dark. It's also a great place for different dance crews to come do their performances at night, practice, and make sure that they are up to speed before one of their competitions. I also really like Paul Mirage because not only is it secluded, but it does have its own Starbucks. So if the line is too long at Biological Sciences or in the Student Center, head over to Paul Mirage, and there's usually never a line there. So that is always a great perk to campus when you are looking to get a caffeine fix for the day.
So for the alumni that are actually looking to connect with students on campus, especially during this time, there's a wide variety of different programs that you can do. I really recommend that you go check in with the Alumni Association. That association really checks in with students. There is a young Alumni Association with just recent grads come out and find support students in different ways. Next one that I absolutely love is Dinners with Anteaters. So an alumni can actually host dinners with students. In the past, alumni have invited students into their homes and just made some meals or just like going to restaurants, and they just really talk about the specific major that they're in and different career fields that they're also in as well. Alumni and students still connect over Zoom, and I do encourage you, for the alumni and for the students as well, if you really want to get embedded into making those connections and networking, you just seek that out. There is something called the Anteater Network. Check it out, it's online. You can actually, it's kind of like a Facebook page for alumni and for students, which is really nice. And students, it's all free for students and alumni.
Even though we might not all be on campus right now, we are still evolving and making sure all of our resources are acceptable to anyone and everyone that has been a part of the Anteater community. So if you are looking for ways to, you know, reach your hand out to certain students, whether it be in your major, your department, or if you just need to find a hire for a certain job, if you are looking for something, this is a great time to really start looking for students that are eager to really get out there. Well, this has been a great time, everyone. Thank you for joining us today. This will go down as one of my new favorite memories that I have on campus, even though I haven't had many different experiences this year, my senior year. I'm very excited to have done this, not just with my coworker, but my friend Adam. Oh. So we thank you all for joining us today. And if you have any questions, you know, reach out to the Student Alumni Association and just reach out to different departments and things like that. And we hope to see you on campus once everything is safe and well. So stay safe, everyone, and happy 2021 and happy homecoming.
Happy homecoming, everyone.